So hello everyone. I couldn't think of a better name for this. I don't know if it's gonna be a daily thing. We'll see. But this is Spelunkin. This is a game that came out a couple years ago on Xbox Live. Pretty recently on PlayStation 3 and Vita, and much longer ago if you're aware of the original PC game. We're calling it Daily Spelunky right now because there's a thing called the Daily Challenge, which is a random seeding of the game, and it's called the seed because the game is randomly generated out of certain pieces and certain actions that can occur in each stage. And then in the world, and so one seed is generated for everyone, and everyone runs through that, and then there are leaderboards and such to go along with that. And I feel like I'm allowed to call this Daily Spelunky because, according to several people who have pointed out to me, I came up with the name Daily Dota on a podcast, as an off remark a while ago. So Daily Dota is my name, is what I'm saying, and so I'm just retaking it by calling this Daily Spelunky. I feel like that's only fair. So I've actually done most of my practice runs in this game on the Vita version. Because I was watching football all weekend, I needed something to do during games that I wasn't necessarily invested in, and so I picked up Spelunky on Vita. I really should have picked it up when it was on sale, but instead I paid full price. So we're going to do a couple practice runs before I do the daily challenge. I've never done the daily challenge before, so... nor have I done this game while streaming. Wait, what happened down there? I'm actually more used to the Vita controls. So, my guess is we could have some interesting starts to this right off the bat. Woo, see, look, I was rewarded. Hey, buddy. Last night, on the Vita version, I had, I had my best run of the game yet. See? Look at that, buddy. Get out of there. I made it to something called the Mothership, which I was not even aware that was a level in the game. I've tried to not look at too much. I've wanted the game to be kind of a surprise as much as possible. You know, I've been looking up some tips, and there's, you know, people say things to me on Twitter, so I start to pick up on some general thoughts on how you're supposed to play Spelunky. You know, there are, you know, things that are considered god-tier items you can pick up in the game, such as the jetpack, and the jetpack is kind of the universal one that everyone seems to love. I also love the shotgun quite a bit because it makes the jungle, which is the second world, really manageable. So I already consider this a victory that I made it past the first stage. Because even though I'm really good at this point at making it through the mines, you know, sometimes stuff... Look at that. All right. Okay, so shotgun. So let's remember that. Let's go get some money. And a lot of what I think about is fascinating about Spelunky is that, you know, I'm starting to play Dark Souls right now, too. And the games have quite a bit in common, I feel like. Man, I don't really want to waste a bomb on that. Oh, jeez, now I'm in bad shape in both ways. No, I can use this to grab this. So a lot of, you always want to be carrying something in Spelunky. Because, especially in the mines, there are all these traps. I am going to go for that shotgun, so... I should have gone in here. I don't think my bomb... is my bomb gonna make it all the way in there? Nope. Okay, so... I'm now making a calculated risk really early in my run. That I'm not gonna run out of bombs or run into a situation where I need the bombs. Because I'm hoping that the shotgun... Damn it. See, I still make dumb mistakes like that. All the time. But now I have enough for the shotgun. Which I feel like is... I don't know. I've just gotten really good at using that. Don't shoot that guy. Let's Let's see. I could. So now I can use that in order to kind of clean up the rest here. Keep using my shotgun to trigger the other little statues there. I assume I dropped it. Okay. There's my shotgun. You can get the shotgun in a couple different ways. In addition to picking it up from a shop, you can also, if you come across an infested zombie map, which is one of the randomly generated levels. Anything over here? No. You can. There's actually a graveyard, and the graveyard, you can. There'll be different graves, and one of them is labeled ash. And if you, underneath that is a shotgun, which I think is awesome. I hate those really big spiders. I got a decent number of little ropes, so I'm gonna go ahead and kind of use up some of those. Because I've got the shotgun, I'm not that worried about my health. Where is that? Now that key is not something you necessarily. You need in order to open a special chest, which if the key is in the level, then the chest is also in the level. I don't see it up here in this first section, which means it's somewhere else. But now I'm gonna have to try and traverse the level with the key, which, based on this section, man, okay, so I'm gonna have to jump down, shoot that, and then jump to the left, and hope. Okay. Actually went pretty well. I thought I was going to trigger the spider. So we see if we can find. Oh man, I can't believe I didn't trigger that big spider. That's a really good sign. That's also one of those things that has gotten me a million times, or sometimes those skeletons come back to life. They are not actually dead. You always want to be looking down. Tossing things down. So if you can jump on the skeletons, that's useful. Always throwing things, trying to trigger traps. I don't think I'm going to worry about that. Okay, perfect. Actually, maybe. So all I need to do is check and make sure there's not a shopkeeper. And if there's not a shopkeeper, then we can actually do everything this level has to offer. Okay. So we're gonna do. Drop that. Come on. Oh, shit. This is bad. And then I died. Fuck! I was doing so well, I had the shotgun. God damn it. Son of a bitch. If I had this frickin' key. Alright, let's do another one. Look at me, I was all explaining things. I felt really good about it. I had the shotgun early in my run, which. If I get the shotgun, I usually make it pretty deep. Once you have the shotgun and you're in the jungles, you're pretty much golden. Let's give that another. We'll do, I don't know what, two runs? That was a. Ooh. Fuck! I even knew that was gonna happen. I should have dropped. So one of the things that several folks have told me about that Well, that doesn't kill them, huh? God, okay. That I've heard from several people is that once you have one good run, or like maybe doing only one run a day is useful because you're kind of your most cautious your first run, and after that, you know, the frustration builds and you just might not be as effective. But also, the music in this game is so goddamn good, like I don't mind listening to it a million times. Screw you, Spider. Probably the ones that the bits that frustrate me the most are when there's sort of a hidden spike, you know, that shoots those little things off on the side of the screen that you just can't even see or account for, which is just really just bad luck. But you know, bad luck is sort of the whole point. Okay, well at least now I can take it reasonably another hit. The thing I've really enjoyed so far about Spelunky is that it truly is really satisfying as you spend more time with it. Because even though it presents itself as an action game, it totally isn't. Like it's a puzzle game, probably is a better way of thinking of it. Because really, with the exception of like times where maybe things kind of happen a little bit off screen, and maybe it's just really maybe you can actually deal with all the off screen things. And no, you can throw a rock. That's why, you know, one of these Spelunky tips is ABC. You know, always be caring. But as you come to, here we go. Okay, so this is gonna end pretty well. As you come to understand the reasons that you die, it truly does become easier. Like you still make stupid mistakes. Like you still die for dumb reasons. Like I just did, even though I had the freaking shotgun, which means I would have been well on my way to collecting enough cash to go to. There's something called the black market, which is why you grab that special key, then you get this. Little object. I'm not even sure what it is. Is an Ankh? It's not an Ankh, but it's whatever. The little eye. And that eye glows when you're near the black market door. And in the black market, you can buy, I mean, it's all randomly seated, so you, oh wow, 3 crates? Maybe the game knew I had a bad run, and it feels bad. Well, I didn't get any special items. But that stocks me up on bombs, which I am not gonna complain about. Because even if you have a ton of items, you can get deep into a run, and if you just run out of bombs, you're kind of screwed. Okay. So I'm just gonna have to run away from that guy. Now we need to check and see if there's a shopkeep, because then I might want to come back and grab that. That's going to require 2. Oh, that guy's kind of screwing up my plans. You can attack that the big spider, but he requires so much damage that it's really not. I like that. One of the things that I learned early on that frustrated me is if you throw up a rock, that gains momentum on its way back down, and not only will it hurt other enemies, but it will hurt you. Oh, someone says throw a bomb at the webbing under the big spiders. That's a really smart Spelunky tip. Thank you. I've actually now played enough that like I'm starting to notice when some of the repeat seeding happens. So there's nothing over here. I could just go down there. There's always a path through the level without using anything. It's only when you start to decide, exploring that, you'll run into other stuff. But now that I've got so many bombs because of the last area, trigger any traps. Fuck! I'm still actually having trouble with the pixel width with the when you whip. So that's what got me into trouble right there. Let's see if I can. Okay. I don't want to spend too much time because that ghost is gonna be coming pretty soon. So I'm actually gonna work on bombing my way out. Oh my god, really? I kind of cut my losses. This is fortunate, but I'm gonna have to use a lot of bombs to make my way through, but... Oh wow, this is awesome. The game often seems to reward you with bombs in those crates. Sometimes you'll get, like, really sweet... loot, but that's... not always the case. Perfect. Could not have asked for something better than that. Someone said I missed a pickaxe. Hey, sometimes brown items blend into the background. All right, the dead are restless. All right, that means there is a graveyard here. I need to be careful not to hit these tikis. So we're looking for a grave that says Ash. Oh! I don't want to mess with that. I wonder if that's a secret character. So I haven't seen Ash yet. Man, I haven't seen that guy. Die, buddy. I think this is a secret character. Or no, I guess. Okay, so there's Ash. So now I can bomb this. And now I feel... oh, look at that. There's the end of the stage. Holy shit, there's a golden cape just sitting there. Oh my god. Woo! There we go, baby. Feeling good about that. Okay. So this, I'm feeling pretty good after this one, though. I feel like I got, you know, feet underneath me. I'm getting used to the Xbox controller. Ooh, I don't like that. Okay, why don't we do this? I'll destroy that. Won't disrupt the shopkeep. Bye, kiss. I don't know how many times I've screwed up these vine jumps, but now I don't have to because I have a cape. That's right, I have a cape. Ah, I have a cape. I didn't have to worry about using that bomb. Idiot. One of the things that I find myself doing when I play this game on subsequent runs is that you forget the items you have, or you think you still have items that you no longer have. So that makes short work of all of these monkeys. Those monkeys can be a huge pain in the ass. Those bullets travel really far. Huh? Okay. Look at that, 2-2. So at this point, I'm feeling pretty good. I've got good money. I'm looking for the black market. I'll come back up if for some reason that makes sense. I would also love Wow. That was a super fortunate bounce. Holy shit. The entrance to the black market is in one of these stages. It's just a matter of finding it now. It is not glowed yet, so I'm going to assume it's just not in this stage, but so far I'm doing pretty good with the shotgun. Boom. God, the amount of times I've screwed up. Hit those tikis. I'd also love... There it is! Okay, there's the jetpack. Wow. Guys. Wait, how do I get rid of... Can you get rid of an item? Do I need to... Can you not... Am I screwed? You can't have the cape and that? How can I... Oh, man. Oh, there we go. Sorry. I don't know that's how you swap items. Okay, so now we are rolling. Whoop. The only thing I could go for now is a compass. A compass will actually point you in the right direction of the end of the level. Got some extra time. So I'm gonna go ahead and rescue her. Set my shotgun down. Hey, lady. I gotcha. Man, this run looked has taken some twists and turns. I never seem to find the Hey, Tunnel Man. Give me two bombs. Of course you can have those. So I never found the black market, but that's okay because I have both objects that I wanted out of the black market, with the exception of the compass. The compass is super useful here. Because the compass will help you find places. The first time I made it here to the caves, I had a jetpack and a shotgun. But then I didn't know that the jetpack runs out of fuel. Fuel? That scared me for a second. Okay, that's the end. Look at that. Boom. Man, I don't want to jinx myself, but we should probably go right through the ice caves. They're pretty easy with the shotgun and the jetpack. Oh, wow. I'm not gonna mess with that. What am I doing? Just courting death. One thing you definitely don't need to do in this game is fight enemies unnecessarily. You don't get anything for it. Whoa! Whoa! Buddy, I didn't do nothing! Oh, man. Alright, well. He's clearly pissed. I don't know what I did, though. Where are you, exit? Must be down here on the right. Yep. I got time, so I might as well rescue her. Wow. This is not how I expected my first set of runs to go. I feel like I'm peaking way too early. I've pissed off all the small business owners here in the ice caves. That's unfortunate. Which I guess. So I know that there is an Ankh you can collect in the game, which probably has to do with that. That's probably like a secret entrance, huh? But I haven't delved that far into the other weirdness that you can get into in Spelunky. Ooh. Oh man. Shopkeeper just chilling. Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't have been guarding the cave. Screw you. Alright. Whoa! What were all those bombs that just went off? Give me a compass. So there's the entrance to the mothership. I did that last night. Man, I'm playing with fire here. But I don't want to really do that. I want to try and find the entrance to the temple, which I've never seen. And that's going to be right there. So what do you say? Should we like throw a bomb at him? Ha! Whoa, whoa! Man, I could not be getting luckier with these runs! Holy balls. So I've never been to the temple. You guys are seeing my first run on the temple. This is exciting. Boom. Achievement unlocked. And I got all these shopkeepers pissed at me. Whoa! What the? The heavy stone blocks imbued the spirit of the Pharaoh's palace guard. Damn. Man, I really wish I had the compass. What? Where the fuck did that guy go? Oh! Oh Oh yeah, go ahead and be pissed down there. What the fuck? Woo! 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 Oh man! Unbelievable! Feeling good! What is that? It's like a secret door. Gotta bring a key all the way down here. Yeah, I'm not messing with that. Give me a compass. Give me a compass. Okay, I'll take those. Who? Whoa. Holy balls. Oh, man. Oh! This temple is serious business. Oh, are you guys really just gonna chill down there? Ah! Oh man, palms are sweaty. Palms are sweaty. Oh, I killed that guy. I don't know why I'm even collecting the money anymore. I do not trust those traps. I'm just gonna kinda. I got bombs, I'm just gonna kinda work my way down. Whoa! Man, trying to do all this without a shotgun, I can't even imagine. Oh, there's the next one. Okay. Damn it! Is there another one? Oh, what is- I don't even know what to do! I've never made it this far before! Okay. Hey, buddy. Okay, I think I know you have to get him to crash down, right? Whoa! Whoa! Can I go on top of him? Ooh, buddy. Man, what's going on here? Look at all this shit. Does this just break it? Like... So just like... Hey, buddy. Palms are sweaty. I don't want to go up there. So should I just keep... I guess I have an effective strategy with, Aw, come on. Well, that didn't work out. Okay. I think I'm just gonna... What now? I don't have that many more bombs. So you're just gonna keep doing this. Okay. So you probably just have to shove yourself down there. So really, I just need to like... I don't know what's down there. I wonder... Okay, so that's... That's right on top. Okay. I think I know what I can do. Damn it! No! No! Come on, fall down there, you piece of shit! Oh my God! Oh! Ah! How can you... No!
I don't have the will to live.
Oh my God. Oh. I want to end my life. I guess it's time for the daily challenge. After all of my will has been sapped from me. Oh, I can't. Son of a. Yo, girl! Let's do this! Nothing in life can be as good as what just happened. Look, I hit A again and I can't even jetpack. Now my hands are all clammy. I'm in a horrible spot to... try and do this, but... Well, that's Spelunky for you. That was you know what? That was incredible. That was so much fun. I cannot believe I did that. Oh, wow. Like, to anyone that, you know, thinks Spelunky is too hard, it's not a game they can play, like, I only started playing it on Friday. And that's the amount of progress I've already made. I made it to Olmec, which, for some people, is where they just consider that's Spelunky's endpoint. There's a lot more stuff you can do in the game at that point, but... for a lot of people, that's where they just kind of call it quits. That's not worth it. Climbing gloves. I really like the climbing gloves because they can really save you from a lot of heartache. Oh, that's right, I have climbing gloves. Don't think I'm gonna get enough to go and buy the cape. Oh wait, yeah I am. Hey lady, why don't you hang out here? Spider webs. Don't think I'm gonna have enough time to come back and get the. Alright, okay. You know, getting a little of my confidence back. I don't have a shotgun, but you know what? Everyone's gotta start somewhere. And right now I'm starting with this cape, I'm starting with these climbing gloves. I'm feeling pretty good about it. I can't believe I made, like, the most newbie mistake possible, which is to crack open one of those without being a certain distance away. I cannot believe I did that. Well, this sucks. So now I gotta be careful, there's all sorts of snakes and spiders, but I'm fortunately pretty well equipped to take care of a section like this. I think, anyway. Like, the one thing you want to do when you're in these sections is just be throwing rocks around. You want to make sure that you're triggering anything that might be around the corner. Yeah, it's just better to be overly cautious. Oh, wow. What a run, you guys. That's awesome. I am Damn it. I actually got saved there. I somehow didn't. I'll take all this money. Take those bombs. Alright, so, well, at least I'm well prepared for, if I find another shop. Alright, all the adrenaline has now left me. I feel okay. Get over here. I can't take care of you guys. Damn it. That won't be the first time or the last time that I do that. Does that work? Look at that. Nice job. Thank you for that tip, chap. What do you say? Should we try and, what do you say we sacrifice her? Let's see what the gods give us. The gods have been watching. They must feel bad for me. I got 5 health, so I feel okay about it. Ah. I'm not a huge fan of the spring boots because I like the Spelunky jump physics as they are, or at least I'm still getting used to them. So, like, I don't really need something else to mess up my game. Yeah, we should be at the end right over here. Oh yeah, the white goo that I picked up is glue, and it makes your bomb stick, so, you know, if you're going for a precision throw, that's what you want there. Ah! Damn it. That is, of course, the consequence of the sticky gloves is that you stick to stuff, which can be a problem sometimes. Especially because I'm still getting to understand the rock trajectory, so sometimes I will just straight up screw those up. I should probably explore a little bit before just moving on to the next section. Oh! Famous last words. Let's go ahead and just move on to the next section. Although I think, like, the aims of Daily Spelunky are different, right? It's actually about collecting money. Not necessarily about length. I'm not totally sure on that. Oh, man. Okay. I have not used this gun. Oh! Freeze ray? Okay, sure. I'll take a gun. I'll take any gun. Oh, that's right. That guy explodes. Boom. Get out of here. You get out of here too. Bop. Nope, that's a dead one. That's a dead one, Jim. Fuck! I'm just gonna leave you behind, sweetie. I will take these bombs, though. Man, it is weird how, and this is something that happens very subtly over time, is in just this weekend of me kind of playing casually, man, I don't like that at all. I'm just gonna avoid that. Me playing casually on my Vita, I went from, you know, dying in 1-1 all the frickin' time, to just sort of like casually streaming and discussing my strategies, and making it to... Oh, shoot. And that is Daily Spelunky. Ah! Beat Chris Remo. So you know what? Today was a victory. So I guess it is by money. I guess I need to get some more friends on here, that are buddies of mine that are doing the Daily Spelunky. But yeah, that's the Daily Spelunky. I don't know if we'll do it every day, but I do want to do it regularly. And after that run we just had, I feel like that gives the best taste of what happens in Spelunky. You get so close, you get so anxious, you get so nervous, and then it all goes to shit. It all just goes to shit. So you should play Spelunky too. We'll maybe return tomorrow, later this week. I don't know. We'll see. But I'm going to play some more Spelunky. Not now, but, like, soon. So, welcome to 2014, everybody. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you guys soon.